Hi everyone, welcome back to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. Today we'll be doing a GPS and heart rate accuracy test with the Amazfit GTR2 as well as the Huawei Watch Fit. The benchmark for the test for the heart rate accuracy will be the Polar H10 ECG chest strap, and for the GPS accuracy the benchmark will be the Polar Beat app on an iPhone 12. Anyway, let's get into it.
If you are new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way.
Right, so just before we get into the actual numbers, let's take a look at the two contenders. So one of them is the Amazfit GTR2. So this is the flagship of the Amazfit range. Well, you've got the GTR2 and the rectangular face, the GTS2. But in this case, this is a 1.39-inch AMOLED display. It's got offline voice commands, it's got a Bluetooth speaker, it's got a mic. You can talk into it, you can take calls right off this watch. Nope, it doesn't carry a SIM card, but when connected to your smartphone, it can actually take calls right off the watch face and you can talk into the watch. On the GTR2, you get over 90 sport modes. And not only that, the sport modes are actually goal-based and they've got further optionality with things like pace alerts, heart rate ranges, auto pause. So there's a lot of optionality on this flagship right here. It's waterproof up to 50 meters. It's got dual GPS. It's got your breathing app. It can monitor three sleep stages, so your light, your deep, and REM sleep. It's got PAI, the personal activity index. So a single value that measures your cardiovascular health in terms of steps taken, quality of your sleep, and the intensity at which you worked out at. It can monitor your stress. It can monitor your continuous heart rate. And of course, it does have SpO2, so it can measure your blood oxygen saturation, but only on demand or as a spot reading. There are plenty more apps in this very cool smartwatch. And yes, it does look like a classic smartwatch, 47 millimeters in diameter. So it's got a classic watch type. Click on strap, the clasp is watch type, and you'll be happy to know that the clasp is actually metal. The lugs on these things are also metal, which make it so sturdy and so versatile. The display specs here are amazing, 326 ppi, that's 454 by 454 pixels. There are plenty of watch faces that you can download from the Zep app. As well as that, you can upload custom watch faces to your watch. And the best thing about Amazfit smartwatches is that you can either use an iOS device or an Android device. Either way, you'll be fine. Anyway, let's talk about the Huawei Watch Fit. The Huawei Watch Fit is more of a basic smartwatch. It's supposed to be the initial step in the smartwatch range of Huawei smartwatches, and yet it offers a big bang for the buck. So for about £80 or $80, you get a 1.64-inch AMOLED display, also with a pixel density of 326 ppi. You get a huge display, 1.64 inches. It's edge to edge. It is rectangular on your wrist. For that very budget price, you do get a waterproof design. You also get dual inbuilt GPS. As well as that, you get 95 sport modes, which are goal-based. You get a running app. So that's a dedicated running app with 13 running courses that can take you from being a newbie to being an expert runner. And you get guided courses as you run along. Then of course, there's the animated workouts. So there's 44 animated gestures in 12 workouts that you can do. And these animated gestures are absolutely awesome because they actually show you how to do a particular exercise. There's also the breathing app. It can monitor your heart rate, your three sleep stages. It's got stress monitoring. And a very important fact about the Huawei Watch Fit is that now, after the recent update, you actually get continuous SpO2 readings. So that's continuous blood oxygen saturation during your moments of rest. So mostly that's during the night. And we've actually tested the accuracy on the Huawei Watch Fit and it's continuous SpO2 readings. And the accuracy is up there with the best in class. In fact, it's similar to a medical device, and I'll leave a link to that video just above me right now. Okay, so we've introduced the two contenders. Let's get into the numbers. And as I've said earlier, we're going to be doing a heart rate accuracy test and then the GPS accuracy test. Let's do it. So let's start talking about heart rate accuracy. First of all, let's take a look at what the benchmark was. So the benchmark readings from the Polar H10 ECG chest strap were 128 beats per minute as the average heart rate and 172 beats per minute as the max heart rate measured by the ECG chest strap. This was actually all part of my exercises in the park or a bit of forest land. So I was taking runs, I was doing some lunges, I was doing squats, then I was walking in those periods when I was a bit tired. So all over in about an hour, I covered about 5 kilometers within this foresty park. So first of all, let's cover off Huawei Watch Fit. So it actually came up with a heart rate average of 123 beats per minute and the max was registered at 165 beats per minute. And straight away, if we look at this plot, we can see that the Huawei Watch Fit just doesn't register those peaks as registered by the Polar H10. And we can see it across three major zones. So somewhere around the 25 minute mark, the 40 minute mark, and the 50 minute mark. The peaks are just not picked up, and hence the lower average as well as the lower max. So the variances are -3.9 on the average and -4.1% on the max heart rate. Nonetheless, the tracing of the heart rate is actually picked up quite well on the optical heart rate sensor of the Huawei Watch Fit. So there's no issue with that. It's just the peaks. Now let's take a look at what the Amazfit GTR2 brings to us. If we look at the numbers, the Amazfit GTR2 does look like it's got something better. So the average heart rate on the Amazfit GTR2 was 127 beats per minute. That's just an underestimation of 1 beat per minute or 0.8%. Now with the max, the max registered was 169 beats per minute. That's just 3 beats per minute under 172 as registered by the Polar H10, giving us a variance of just 1.7%. But if we look at the tracing across the map, we can see that yes, the peaks and the troughs, they're registered and they're traced quite well, but there are occasions where there are hits and misses. And we can see evidence of that where we see some overestimation during the 20 minute mark and then some underestimation during the 25 minute mark. Overall though, very impressed with the Amazfit GTR2. It has shown us that it is much closer to the Polar H10 ECG chest strap. And now let's take a look at the GPS accuracy. And before we do, we need to set the scene. So as I was running through this forest or the park, so it's got hills, there's a lot of trees, a lot of plants all around me. So a lot of reflections. And of course, the benchmark, which is the PolarBeat app on my iPhone 12, has shown a distance covered in the 1 hour and 7 minutes of 5.04 kilometers. So that is the benchmark. Let's take a look at what these smartwatches have actually come up with using their dual GPS. So again, kicking off with the Huawei Watch Fit, we can see that it registered a distance of 4.56 kilometers. That's an understatement of about 480 meters or 0.5 of a kilometer over a distance of 5 kilometers. That's a variance of just under 10%. That is quite significant. Although we've seen differences with the Huawei Fit as much as 15 and 20%. So 10% does not seem that bad, well, in comparison to the 15 and 20%, but still, it's quite significantly off the mark. Let's take a look at what the Amazfit GTR2 GPS has actually measured. And we can see that the Amazfit GTR2 has actually measured 4.94 kilometers. That's just 100 meters off the mark, and that is 2%. So it's off from the benchmark by just 2%. That's a very sharp result. So let's summarize. We've got the flagship from the Amazfit GTR2, and then we've got the Huawei Watch Fit, which is the first step in the smartwatch range of Huawei. but these two smartwatches are quite accurate. In regards to heart rate accuracy, the GTR2 does do a better job than the Huawei Watch Fit. If we look at the dual GPS, then yes, the GTR2 does better as well. But there is one point that I love about the Huawei Watch Fit, and that's the fact that it can do continuous SpO2 monitoring. But the GTR2 does cost more because of its premium features as well as its premium looks. And it does have a microphone. It does have offline voice commands. It's got a speaker. It's got an amazing display. And it just looks quite rich. But anyway, thanks for watching this review, comparison, and test. If you did enjoy us, please leave us a like. And if you want to see more of the same, please hit the red subscribe button below the video. And I'll see you in the next one.